Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2023 Homecoming Ceremony, sponsored by Greenboro High School Student Council. Tonight, we bring the fun of Homecoming Week to a close with a presentation of our Homecoming Court and crowning of our 2023 Homecoming Queen. Each class is represented by two girls who were nominated and voted on by members of their class to represent them on the court. The senior class has three representatives, one of which will be crowned tonight's queen. Without further ado, we present to you the 2023 Homecoming Court. Representing the freshman class is Miss Riley Maddox. Riley is the daughter of Angela Maddox and is on the cheer team and a honor roll. Escorting Riley are Brian Rankhorn and Carson Wood. Brian is the son of Pamela and Brian Rankhorn and has played GHS football for 4 years. Carson is the son of Alyssa and James Wood and has played GHS football for 4 years. Also representing the freshman class is Miss Jalen Pearsall. Jalen is the daughter of Crystal and Jamie Pearsall and is on the volleyball and softball teams. Escorting Jalen are Braden White and Dalton Wilbur. Braden is the son of Stephanie and Luke White and has played GHS football for 3 years. Dalton is the son of Heather and Daniel Wilbur and has played GHS football for 4 years. Representing the sophomore class is Miss Kennedy Cantrell. Kennedy is the daughter of Kelly and Anthony Cantrell. She has a 4.0 GPA and is the sophomore class president. Escorting Kennedy are Tyler Adams and Walter Caucus. Tyler is the son of Valerie and Justin Adams and has played GHS football for 4 years. Walter is the son of Kerry Caucus and has played GHS football for 2 years. Also representing the sophomore class is Miss Caitlin Cooper. Caitlin is the daughter of Lisa and John Counts and is on the AB honor roll. Escorting Caitlin are Reese Jones and Landon Schrock. Reese is the son of Tammy Jones and has played GHS football for 4 years. Landon is the son of Jess and Zach Schrock and has played GHS football for 4 years. Representing the junior class is Miss Ella Honeycutt. Ella is the daughter of Bethany and Brian Honeycutt and is our junior class president. Escorting Ella are Carter DeMarcus and Wesley Buckner. Carter is the son of Christy and Daniel DeMarcus and has played GHS football for 4 years. Wesley is the son of Marcia and James Buckner and has played GHS football for 4 years. Also representing the junior class is Miss Elsie Humes. Elsie is the daughter of Chelsea Humes and is in National Honor Society. Escorting Elsie are Bryson Meeks and Dagan Smith. Bryson is the son of Alicia and Mike Meeks and has played GHS football for 4 years. Dagan is the son of Amy Walter and Davin Smith and has played GHS football for 2 years. Representing the senior class is Miss Lauren Akande. Lauren is the daughter of Melissa and Stephen Akande. Lauren is on the cheer club and involved in multiple other clubs. Escorting Lauren are Travarius Flood and Will White. Travarius is the son of Amanda Flood and Tremaine White and has played GHS football for 4 years. Will is the son of Sheila and Carney White and has played GHS football for 2 years. Also representing the senior class is Miss Brooklyn Garcia. Brooklyn is the daughter of Brandy and Marcus Jordan. Brooklyn has a 4.0 GPA and is on the A honor roll. Escorting Brooklyn are Nolan Carson and Max Skurlock. Nolan is the son of Amanda and James Carson and has played GHS football for 4 years. Max is the son of Corey and John Skurlock and has played GHS football for 4 years. Our third representative for the senior class is Miss Kendall Reese. Kendall is the daughter of Melissa and Corey Reese. Kendall has been a GHS cheerleader for 4 years and is in Student Council, National Honor Society, Beta Club, and FCCLA. Escorting Kendall are Jackson All and Nate Castleman. Jackson is the son of Amanda and Jimmy All and has played GHS football for 4 years. Nate is the son of Anna Hampton and Trey Castleman and has played GHS football for 4 years. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please join us in welcoming back last year's homecoming queen, Miss Evelyn Suggs. Evelyn is accompanied tonight by Parker Sorrells and Andrew Criswell. Parker is the daughter of Kayla and Jim Sorrells, and Andrew is the son of Catherine and Kevin Criswell. And now the moment we have all been waiting for. Greenbrier High School's 2023 homecoming queen is Miss Kendall Reese. Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present to you the 2023 homecoming queen, Kendall Reese, and her court. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise as you are able and direct your attention to midfield as the Robertson County Air Force JROTC presents this evening's colors. Following the posting of colors, please remain standing for a moment of silence and pregame invocation, followed by the playing of our national anthem by the Greenbrier High School Marching Bobcats. Tonight's moment of silence will be dedicated to the family of Madeline Rutledge. Madeline was a 2017 graduate of Greenbrier High School who was killed in a tragic car accident this past weekend. During her time at Greenbrier High School, she was a very talented cheerleader, member of the National Honor Society, Beta Club, and Show Choir. She could always be found tumbling across the fields and gyms with her beautiful flips. After graduating from Greenbrier, she went on to earn a major in psychology with a minor in child and family studies from the University of Tennessee in Knoxville. After her college graduation, she began working at the Howell Allen Neurology Clinic at Ascension St. Thomas. She would have finished her medical assistant program in October and had plans to work her way into neuropsychology nursing. She loved her job and the people she worked with. Madeline was one of a kind with her sweet and gentle spirit. Her smile lit up a room, and she was a blessing to be around. While her family is completely devastated by the loss of their precious girl, they know without a doubt Madeline was a believer of Jesus Christ and is wrapped in his loving arms. In honor of Madeline Rutledge, the cheerleaders are wearing bows with her initials at the game tonight. We would like to also dedicate our moment of silence to her and her family this evening. Please join us in a moment of silence for Madeline Rutledge's life and her family as they grieve the loss of their daughter. Thank you. At this time, we invite you to join Greenbrier High School Junior and FCA leader Tabitha Lawrence as she provides tonight's invocation.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for giving us the opportunity to play tonight. Please watch over the football teams as they play tonight and give each one of the students athletes the courage to play this game in a manner which is pleasing to you. May each team exhibit a spirit of sportsmanship and respect while playing competitively for the win. We ask for your blessings over all the coaches, officials, parents, and players. It's in Jesus' name we say, amen.
Good evening. This is Chief Meteorologist Tom Sorrells from WKMG Orlando, Florida, 1981 graduate of Greenbrier High School. Hey, gang, wish I could be with you tonight. I'm down here in Hurricane Central in recovery mode. I sure wish I could be there for homecoming. The weather is near perfection. 7 o'clock temperature is 80 with sunshine. By 8 o'clock, we're clear, 78. A light breeze from the southeast, 5 to 10 miles per hour. And then by 9 o'clock, we are still clear. The temperature reading is 76. Let's go get a big homecoming victory. Go Cats, go!
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's projected Bobcat starter. On offense, at wide receiver, number 11, Travarius Flood. At wide receiver, number 17, Nate Castleman. At tight end, number 3, Luke Meyer. At tackle, number 79, Reese Jones. At guard, number 56, Jackson All. At center, number 64, Gavin Landreth. At guard, number 50, Aiden Edwards. At tackle, number 78, Logan Lorenz. Halfback, number 89, Tyler Adams. At tailback, number 30, Carson Wood. And the quarterback for your Bobcats, number 9, Nolan Carson. Handling kickoff and punt duties for the Bobcats, number 38, Will White. And now your projected defensive starters for the Bobcats. At defensive end, number 91, Landon Schrock. At nose guard, number 79, Reese Jones. At defensive end, number 54, Preston Pointer. Inside linebackers, number 40, Owen Hasler. And number 89, Tyler Adams. Outside linebackers, number 3, Luke Meyer. And number 24, Dalton Wilbur. Starting at safety, number 2, Max Scurlock. And number 9, Nolan Carson. And at corner for the Bobcats, number 11, Travarius Flood. And number 17, Nate Castleman.
Slowly.
Ladies and gentlemen, here come the Bobcats.
As I was going to say, slowly going to turn myself back up here, but we're going to jump right into it. The Bobcats have taken the field. Homecoming is over. The time is now. No more distraction. It is time to go out there and get that first win of the season, and that's what we hope to see out of Gangrene here tonight. Still about 2.5 minutes before we officially put toe to pig to get rolling here, but thank you for joining us and staying with us so far with this wonderful stream that we got going. I do apologize that the video of the scoreboard is going in and out. That'll be the next thing to troubleshoot. This is all brand new stuff that we're trying to do, and I hope you're all enjoying it. We're trying to take advantage of all the technology that we can around here. So,
at this time, we direct your attention to midfield for tonight's coin toss. Tonight's Bobcat captains, number 30, Carson Wood. Number 60, Wesley Buckner. And number 79, Reese Jones.
And if you can hear it coming from across the way there, White's Creek brought their band. That's awesome. We're really excited about that. So they're going to be playing all night. I guarantee that.
The Bobcats have won the toss and elected to defer their decision until the second half. White's Creek will receive the opening kickoff. The Bobcats will defend the south end zone.
Will White's going to line up his kick to kick it away here. Jordan McKinley, Davion Hooten back deep for the Cobras. That was a blooping kick. The Bobcats have the ball. So it went straight up instead of straight out, like everybody assumed, and everybody was setting up their walls at the 20 and the 25, but that ball bounced at the 35.
Will White's kickoff recovered by the Bobcats at the Cobra 36-yard line. First down, Bobcats.
So we're going to do our best to limit the Jake the Snake Roberts and Randy Orton references with all of the snakes in the building tonight. We've got 12 minutes on the clock and a fresh set of downs. Snakes. I don't know no snakes. First down coming up for the Bobcats. Nolan Carson, he's in the shotgun. Drop it back to pass. Lobs one. Tervarius Flood, first play of the game. My goodness. And we were just talking, you know, Tervarius, is he going to be at 100% tonight?
Nolan Maybe Carson he's. Pass complete to number 11, Tervarius Flood. Touchdown, Bobcats.
We're wondering, maybe is he going to be in a limited role? Not quite sure what kind of action we're going to see, but my goodness, first play of the game, touchdown. And with 7 seconds off the board, Bobcats strike first. White's going to set up his kick. It's up.
Point after attempt is good.
Well, how about that?
With 11 minutes, 53 seconds remaining in the first quarter, your score, Greenbrier 7, Whites Creek 0.
All right, ready to get our next kick underway. White going to bloop it again, this time to the left side, fielded at the 20. Bobbles through his hand, that's 10. That was Dalton Wilbur. Nice to see him back in action. He was almost going back there to make the stop. 10, that was McKinley for the Cobras, dancing around.
McKinley on the return for the Cobras. To the Cobra 27-yard line, first down Whites Creek.
I was told by my friends at work that I should use some Cobra Kai references this week, so we'll see if we can do that. Sweep the leg as we start our second series of the night. Your quarterback is going to be Tadarius Taylor, who is not listed as a quarterback on this roster that we have. Normally lines up in a wide receiver position. 14 on the carry, that's going to be not on our list is who that is. And Tyler Adams coming up with the big stop for the Bobcats. It's going to be a loss, Kevin.
Tyler Adams with the ridgetop collision, tackle for a loss for the Bobcats. It's second down.
Second down and 12 officially. 11 minutes, 19 seconds to go here in the first quarter of play, which you can actually see if you are watching our stream tonight, so thank you. Next play, that ball is tipped up in the air. Luke Meyer getting that big wingspan, putting it to good use, and that'll stop the clock.
White screen pass. Batted down by number 3, Luke Meyer. It's third down.
So Kevin talked about that defensive front. It's nice to see some familiar names back into the lineup. So we're still not officially at 100%, but a lot of guys got some good, valuable reps last week, and we're going to put all of that to test tonight. Third down and 12 coming up here. Ball is at the 25. Your quarterback is still Taylor for the Cobras. He's dancing around, keeping it, running. He's got a big wide open lane. Nolan Carson going low at the knees to cut him down and stop him. He's going to be dangerously close to a first down. Might be a yard or two. No, they're going to give him the spot. They absolutely are just going to give him above, just past the marker. So that'll be a first down pickup there for Taylor. They are not going to measure that. Of course, we're looking at an angle here, and our argument is always going to be, I don't think it
ball
was that.
Ball spotted at the 37-yard line. Result of the play is a first down, Whites Creek.
Clock continues to move here, 10 minutes and 53 seconds. Taylor's in the shotgun. He's got a man just behind him. It's kind of a pistol gun look. He's looking right the entire time. That ball was almost batted and tipped. Dalton Wilbur was coming out of nowhere, flying. One did end up catching that out there on the far side. Tyler Adams, once again, we'll give him credit
pass
for the stop.
To Hooten. Tackled by Tyler Adams for no gain. It's second down.
When we got this roster the other night, I was really excited about that name, and I'm glad to see him in the mix already because I just love that name, Hooten. Second down and 10, ball's at the 37. 10 minutes, 37 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Bobcats struck first. Where you been? You missed all the action already. Second series of the night, and it's the Cobras. Handoff in the backfield. He's met by a host of Bobcats, and there's the first German suplex of the night. Landon Schrock getting in on the action.
Landon Schrock with a ridgetop collision tackle for loss for the Bobcats. Losses to the 34-yard line. It's third down.
Bobcats working with their traditional three-man front for most of this drive here. Now they're walking up a linebacker as soon as I said that. Shotgun look for Taylor. He's dropping back. Blitz. Hit him. Causing a little bit of duress. Now he's rolling. Pitch into one. Incomplete. Matching him step for step there every time was Max Skurlock. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Cobra pass falls incomplete. Brings up fourth down.
So fourth down and 13, ball's at the 34. White's Creek does drop Taylor back into punt formation. Gets the kick away end over end. Flood is back deep to receive it. He's got it at the 30. Plants cuts the other direction. Knee looks fine to me. He's still moving around. He finally caught up before he could make a break for it. Javarius was doing his best to make something out of it.
Javarius Flood on the return for the Bobcats. To the Bobcat 31-yard line. First down, Bobcats.
First and 10 coming up here for the Bobcats, the first true offensive series that we've seen here tonight. Nolan Carson's going to be joined by Carson Wood in the backfield. One wide, DeMarcus, out wide to the left. Handoff goes to Wood. He's running right. Gets around the corner, closing hard there for White's Creek. Was number
Carson
seven.
Carson Wood on the carry for the Bobcats.
I'm going to say that's number seven, Andrew Shute, on the stop.
Gain to the 32-yard line. It's second down.
Second down and nine coming up. Ball's at the 32. Carson directing traffic. He's got everybody loaded to the right side. Out on the far side is going to be Travarius Flood, Nate Castleman. And before we could get the play away, false start signaled against the Bobcats.
Prior to the snap, false start signaled against the Bobcats. It's a 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Eight minutes and 40 seconds here. Second down and 14 coming up for the Bobcats. One thing of note, the 40-second clock is not in operation tonight as the controller has come up missing. Here on second down, Nolan Carson feeling the pressure from the backside. Just ends up falling down about the 20-yard line. No gain, no loss.
Nolan Carson on the carry for the Bobcats. Tackle to the 21-yard line. It's third down.
So when I said no loss, I meant quite a loss, actually. Third down and 20 coming up here. Ball's on the 21. Third down and 20. Carson, he's in the shotgun with Carson Wood to his left. Feeling the pressure. Steps up at the pocket. Scrambles. Takes off. Man throws a block. He's at the 30. Still scrambling around. Luke Meyer, big block. He's at the 40, the 45, 50. First down, Nolan Carson. That is how you set the pick and roll around, Luke Meyer.
Nolan Carson on the carry for the Bobcats. Pushed out of bounds at midfield. And that's a Jimmy All. First down, Bobcats.
I'd like to thank Jimmy All for sponsoring our first downs this year. That was a heck of a block, absolutely. Luke Meyer was in great position there, and that's why you keep going. You don't give up when the play is far away from him. He was over here on the left side as Nolan started out on the right, scrambling around, and by the time he got his footing and saw daylight, great position. First down, ball's at midfield. Tyler Adams, your man in motion, high snap. Carson fakes it. He's rolling right, feeling some pressure. It was a backside blitz, never had a prayer, throws up one himself. That ball's going to sail incomplete. Would have been intended for Nate Castleman, but he was being pushed out of bounds. So that's what this defense is going to do. They're going to line up.
That pass falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
They're going to line up, and they're going to run straight ahead at you. Jet at you is what we used to refer to it as. They're going to jet at you every single time. That did stop the clock with 6 minutes and 54 seconds. Loaded personnel to the left side, tight end and wing. Two receivers wide to the right. Carson dropping back to pass. Feeling the pressure again. He's rolling right. Tries to step up. Doesn't have a chance. Throws it on the run. It's complete. Flood got it on the far side, and he took down Rory over there on the sticks. Actually, I think that may have been Brian May.
Pass complete to number 11, Travarius Flood. Gain to the Cobras, 39-yard line. That's a Jimmy All first down, Bobcats.
Nevertheless, that was a great pitch and catch by Nolan Carson to Travarius Flood. That's the hot tandem. That's what we needed last week, and we're sorely missing it. Glad to see that Brian is okay there on the far side. He took a nice hit with the sticks, but he was held and propped up by a couple of the White Creek Cobras, so it's all good. 6 minutes, 43 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Bobcats on the move with a fresh set of downs. We're going under center. Handoff goes to the fullback, Carson Wood, 3 yards in a cloud of dust. That was 100%.
Handoff number 30, Carson Wood. Short gain on the play.
I was going to say, after
it's
the stalemate, the stalemate there at the line of scrimmage, a short gain at that is what we'll officially have to credit it as. They sure do. They sure do. Talking about the size of White's Creek Band, they ain't got many, as Kevin said, but they sure mighty. 6 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Under center is Carson. Handoff. That's Dalton Wilbur, and he's pulled down by the back of his helmet.
Handoff number 24, Dalton Wilbur.
I can count at least 4 striped shirts that could have seen that.
Carries to the 32-yard line. Will be third down.
That will get us up to 3rd and 3. Ball's at the 32 here. It's a little early for Rocky Top, don't you think? I'd like to send a special shout-out to the Vanderbilt Commodores who lead the SEC in total offense, wins, et cetera, after 1 week. Thank you, Florida. 5 minutes, 7 seconds. Nolan Carson throws up a prayer. He's got Flood. Oh, my goodness. I'm so sorry. I just blew everybody's eardrums. But Travarius Flood twice now.
Nolan Carson pass complete to number 11, Travarius Flood. Steps out of bounds at the 11-yard line. And that's a Jimmy All first down, Bobcats.
We're just excited that we're moving the ball, so I do apologize for that screaming that I just did. But Travarius Flood twice now has broken off the ball and gotten away from his receiver. He is breaking ankles out there. He got free. He made that catch right at the 15-yard line, got that foot in, and got out of bounds. It was incredible. 5 minutes, 1 second to go. Bobcats knocking on the door once again. Ball's at the 11, so we can technically pick up a first down. But that's not the goal. The goal was to just get it across the plane. Carson's directing traffic. He'll have Carson Wood to his right, two wide up top. Flood and Castleman. Carson feeling the pressure. It was a jailbreak. He's able to get the ball away. And Nolan took quite a hit there at the 30-yard line, and he's still down.
There's a flag on the play. Intentional grounding signaled against the Bobcats. Timeout, Bobcats.
Bobcats are going to take a second to think about this. Nolan was trying to tough it out there, but he clearly needs another second to shake that one off. So 4 minutes and 52 seconds. Bobcats struck first on the first play of the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, throughout the game tonight, we'll be recognizing our 2023 Bobcat football sponsors. Their signs are located around the field as well as on the scoreboard. The contributions and donations made by these individuals, businesses, and organizations fund our stadium facilities and projects. We encourage you to support all of our sponsors because they support Bobcat football. Farmers and Merchants Bank, TriStar Northcrest Medical Center, Payne Chevrolet, Greenbrier Pharmacy and Fountain, Rodney Swearingen with Greenbrier Farm Bureau, Greenbrier First Baptist Church, Hall's Custom Cabinetry, Premier Building Group.
Four minutes, 52 seconds to go here in the first quarter of play. An unfortunate situation the previous play there. It's now a second and 30 for the Bobcats. 31 yards to go. Carson feeling the pressure again. Finally getting some help on the backside. He's going to turn on the jets. Makes it back to the line of scrimmage. Spins. Still moving. He's at the 35 before he's finally brought down. So poor guy went about 30 yards to gain five that time. We do have some yellow on the field.
Nolan Carson on the carry. There's a flag on the previous play.
Coming into this contest, we were awfully curious what Whites Creek had. We only had about a game and a half of game film to really look at here. We knew that they had some athletes, and they're certainly
holding,
showing that.
Signaled against the Bobcats. Penalty is declined. Nolan Carson's gain is to the 25-yard line, where it will be third down, Bobcats.
So third down and 24 to go. So we're talking about Whites Creek. We didn't really know what they kind of had. We knew that they had athletes on both sides of the ball, and they're certainly showing that. Coming from this backside every time, they are jetting straight up field and getting the step on them. I would imagine we'll start going on two to kind of throw that rhythm off here in a minute. But what do I know? 4 minutes, 16 seconds as we get back to work here. Carson's in the shotgun. He's got Carson Wood to his left. And another whistle before we get back rolling. Flag was still on the field back here on the shield. So now we're going to get reset. As Carson was getting set, he's got three wide. Down closest to us here as the Bobcats are moving right to left. Castleman and Flood. Carson throws it to Castleman. Head of steam. He's at the 20. And drugged down by his face mask. And we're not going to call it. That's fine. Okay. We
pass complete to number 17, Nate Castleman. To the 17-yard line. Sideline warning, Whites Creek.
Well, that's at least not against us for once.
Gain is to the 17-yard line. It will be fourth down, Bobcats.
Come on, Will White. Fourth down and 16. Will White, who was clamoring for an opportunity a couple weeks ago, is going to get his shot here about 33 yards out. Ball is going to be spotted at the left hash. Snap, set, kick is up. Going. Just off to the side. We thought it may have been good from this angle.
Field goal attempt is no good. Result of the play is a turnover on downs. First down, White's Creek.
I mean, that was the size of a quarter, the miss on that one. Hate that. 3 minutes and 27 seconds to go here in the first quarter of play. Again, Bobcats struck first. If you're just joining us, a big, big play. Nice pitch and catch from Nolan Carson to Javarius Flood. Done that a couple times so far tonight. But White's Creek will get their next opportunity here in just a moment. Looks like that's going to be Taylor again at quarterback for the Cobras. He's in the shotgun. Swallowed up by that defensive line. Big Reese Jones breaking through there. Nice to see him back in the action this week.
Ridgetop collision, tackle for a loss by number 79, Reese Jones.
Second down and 11. Ball is going to be placed at the 19-yard line for the Cobras. Switching around quarterbacks now. That's Tremel Pierce now at the quarterback position for the Cobras. He's going to drop back and throw it. And he is all battered around, intercepted. Max Skurlock's going to come up with the interception.
White's
he was trying to
pass.
Throw that one away.
Intercepted by number two, Max Skurlock.
And it was a meeting of the minds.
Interception return to the 24-yard line. First down,
it was
Bobcats.
A meeting of the minds from Luke Meyer and Landon Schrock. So Luke was on the left side. Landon was on the right side. They are jetting upfield just the way that that White's Creek was done. I will get my creeks and queeks and queens. And I do apologize. I know I really messed up the word queen on that pre-record that was playing all afternoon. But anyways, it was a meeting of the minds, and he tried to throw it away, not much unlike Nolan did a couple series ago. But this time it was picked off. Carson's going to be under center. This is going to be a traditional wing T look. Carson Wood is your fullback. Wood on the carry. He's going to dive straight ahead. Rumbling, bumbling, stumbling.
Carson Wood on the carry for the Bobcats.
None of those numbers are on our roster. 55? G. Nevertheless, second down and nine.
One. Second and nine.
So when we talk about the wing T look, this is what your personnel looks like. You've got Carson Wood at fullback. Your tailback is technically Dalton Wilbur, and your wingback is going to be Tyler Adams. Handoff goes to Wilbur. He's still moving. Finally brought down after the second and third hit to get him. Of course,
Dalton Wilbur on the carry for the Bobcats. No gain on the play. It's third down.
Hey, just a little over a month ago, Dalton was not even with the team. I believe he did have some surgery in the offseason, had some pins removed here, there, everywhere. I'm not quite sure. I know he's had some ankle issues for a couple years now, aggravated it back in the spring playing baseball. Nice to see him back out there. He's still got that full head of steam to him. Third down and 10, ball's at the 24. Shotgun look, Nolan Carson's in the gun. He's got Wood to his right. Tried to get the quick pitch out to Nate Kasman on the far side, but they timed
Bobcat
it just right.
Bobcat pass ball's incomplete. Will be fourth down.
That was William Simpson coming through from the linebacker position for the Cobras to knock that one down. Fourth down and 10. Just a little bit outside of the range that we had just a moment ago. That ball is spotted at the 24-yard line. So, yeah, where he was good, almost good from 33. 40 might be stretching it just a little bit too far. Bobcats are going to line it up and go for it. Fourth and 10 coming up here. Two wide are going to be to the left here for Nolan Carson. He's got Carson Wood to his right, Tyler Adams. Castleman and Flood to the left here. Bobcats moving right to left, and before they could get the snap going.
Prior to the snap, delay of game signaled against the Bobcats.
That's just one of those
unfortunate
penalties.
The 5-yard penalty remains fourth down.
You know, we talked about the 40-second clock not being in operation, but that's got to be something that's always running through your head, not just as a quarterback, but anybody that's out on that field. That stops the clock, 51.4 seconds. Bobcats break the huddle. Carson's in the shotgun. Wood to his left. Flood. Castleman to his left as well. Wide. Wood is your man in motion, moving left to right. Straight drop back. Luke Meyer right in the middle of the field. Got it. That's got to be a first down. It is.
Nolan Carson pass complete to number 3, Luke Meyer.
And so later tonight when you're firing up your NCAA 14.
Ball spotted at the 11-yard line. That's a Jimmy All first down, Bobcats.
You're firing up your NCAA 14. You're going to run a playbook from Iowa, and you're going to call tight end hot with the triangle. That's exactly what the Bobcats just ran right there with 33 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Clock's moving here. Fresh set of downs. Ball's at the 11. So we're kind of in the same spot we were just a little bit ago. First and 10, ball's at the 11. Carson. Hands to Carson. He rumbles ahead
Nolan
across
Carson
the 10-yard line.
Carson on the carry for the Bobcats. To the 8-yard line. It's 2nd and 7, Bobcats.
I think that might run out the clock here. So we're going to flip sides here and get back to work here in just a moment. Folks, you're listening to Homecoming here at Greenbrier.
And that will be the final play of the first quarter. Your quarter score, Greenbrier 7, Whites Creek 0. Continuing our recognition of our great Bobcat football sponsor, Ridgetop Collision Center, Volunteer State Bank, Brandon Frank Construction, Clean Harbor, The Farmers Bank, Viridian Realty Group, Old Hickory Credit Union, Phil Holt, the Get Back Coach of the Bobcat, D1 Electric, Holt Hometown Foods, Drake's Auto, Environmental Concepts, Solid Rock Baptist Church, Crossroads IGA, Church Street Chicken and Barbecue, Bradley Arms with Outlaw Performance Incorporated, Outlaw Inc., HHS Contractors, Jose's Mexican Restaurant, State Senator Kerry Roberts, Agape Church, Golly G's, Advanced Tree LLC, Industrial Staffing of Tennessee, Signature Title Services LLC, CSSI Design Center, Greenbrier Dental Excellence, Triple B Exteriors, Insol Environmental Solutions, Ebenezer Baptist Church, Ascension St. Thomas Urgent Care, Ryan Lanius with RL Lawn Care, and Harley English, Independent Beauty Consultant.
Same problem we run into every week. Trying to get the clock reset here.
Hey, Sheriff, they need to give us control of the clock.
again, trying to get the officials to flip the switch down. Still nothing, Luke. And then here comes the rain at Bobcat Field. Well, we made it through homecoming, ladies and gentlemen. We made it through homecoming before the bottom fell out. Hey, we got the clock fixed. Way to go, Luke. Here we go. Here we go. We're ready to get back to work here. You're wet. We have been joined to the press box by dignitaries as the rain begins to pour here at Bobcat Stadium. Shotgun here for Nolan Carson. He's rolling left. Pitches it out. It's complete as he dives down to the ground. That was Tyler Adams on the reception that time, Kevin.
Nolan Carson pass complete to Tyler Adams. Ball will be spotted at the 6-yard line. It's third down, Bobcats.
So third down and 5 coming up from the 6 here. As we have switched sides of the field, Bobcats moving left to right now. Clock's moving here. Carson, he's going to keep it. Rolling around the right side. Diving up, looking for any kind of position.
Nolan Carson on the carry. No gain on the play. It's fourth down.
There's just no good angle here in the rain. Fourth down and 4 coming up here. Ball is spotted at the 5. Again, the situation is you can pick up a first down. Bobcats are going to take a timeout.
Timeout, Bobcats.
Fourth down and 4, balls at the 5-yard line here. 10 minutes and 33 seconds to go here in the first half of play. Carson's going to be in the shotgun. And before we could get the ball off, another whistle on the flat, or excuse me, another whistle. Offside signaled
prior
against
the
Cobras.
Offside signaled against White's Creek. Penalty is half the distance to the goal. Still fourth down.
So we talked about it earlier. You know, they're jetting upfield every time. They're getting some speed every time. You start going on two, that'll certainly slow them down. It's a good call right there. Fourth down and 2. Ball spotted at the 3-yard line. Carson's in the shotgun. Everybody else is tight in front of him. They just build a wall. They're going to run it straight ahead. Finds a hole. Dives for the pylon in the end zone. He broke the plane.
They're going to say he didn't get it? Are you kidding me? But did he get a first?
I think if he at least did not get credit for the touchdown, he had to have gotten the first down. And that's indeed the case here, Kevin. First down.
Nolan Carson on the carry for the Bobcats. That's a Jimmy All first and goal, Bobcats.
We're going to write on that box in Sharpie, flip this switch at the end of the quarter. Because this is ridiculous. Not after that guy set up here and yelled at me the other night.
First and goal to go from the one, Bobcats. All tight here. We're going to go straight ahead. And that did not work. So second down and four, ball will be spotted at the four this time.
Loss on the play to the 4 yard line. It's second down.
Eight minutes and 40 seconds, second down and four from the four coming up. Bobcats going tight one more time. Carson's in the gun. He's got a wall in front of him to the right side. They're going to run it the other direction. Trying to get outside. Lost his footing out from underneath him. So now be third and goal here. That ball is going to be spotted all the way back at the 15. So they're going to call that actually at the 13. So third down and goal from the 13. Two wide for the Bobcats. Flood and Castleman out to the widest side here to the right. Nolan Carson's in the shotgun. Carson Wood to his right. Snap. Dropping back. Lobs went up to the corner for Castleman. That ball is going to fall incomplete. Some incidental contact that slowed him up.
Bobcat pass falls incomplete. We'll be fourth down.
Fourth down and 13 coming up here for the Bobcats. Bobcats going three wide, two to the right here. Carson, he's dropping back to pass. Throws one over the middle to Flood. Goes up for it. He was hit in midair. That'll fall incomplete, and that'll be a turnover on downs.
Bobcat pass falls incomplete. Result of the play is a turnover on downs. First down, Whites Creek.
So first and 10 coming up for the 13 for the Cobras. Snap is low. Handoff was late in the backfield. All over it there was Landon Schrock.
Ridge stop collision. Tackle for loss. By number 91, Landon Schrock. It's second down.
Clock is moving here. 6 minutes and 48 seconds to go here in the first half of play. Bobcats struck first on the first play of the game. Have had two trips to the end zone, two trips to the goal zone, and unable to convert here. Green zone. There we go. Second down for White's Creek. Handoff goes inside. Diving at feet. Diving at feet once again. Nolan Carson comes up with a stop. Got him right at about the 7-8 yard line.
Hooten on the carry. Tackle by Nolan Carson.
That'll be a loss of one on the play. Third down and 15. Thought it was more like two. Third down and 15 from the 9 coming up.
It's third down.
6 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Your quarterback is Pierce for the Cobras. He's in the shotgun. Snap, hands off inside. Tackled immediately by Dalton Wilbur. Ball slipped out. Max Gerlach fell on it. So Dalton Wilbur was playing his key upfield, watching the fake handoff. The snaps are getting high and low each time, throwing off the timing. And Dalton was able to be right there in his hip pocket as soon as the handoff was made. Fourth down and 14, ball's at the 9-yard line. White's Creek might be content to send the punt team out. Five minutes to go here in the second quarter. Taking a minute to figure it out down there is this crew. Low snap, gets the kick away, not a good kick at all. That's going to bounce at the 20 and roll forward, a very fortunate bounce. That put netted like 3 yards on that time.
Cobra punt is down by the Bobcats. At the Cobra's 14-yard line. It'll be first down, Bobcats.
So first and 10 is going to be coming up for the 14. So they kind of moved the ball around a little bit back right where we started, basically. So in the red zone, let's get to the green zone. 4 minutes and 30 seconds before we get to the half. You want to get another score. You need to get another score right here. Carson's going to break the huddle. They're going to line up under center. Javarius Flood's going to take off. Wide to the left side. Wood, your fullback. Fumble the exchange from center. And Carson's going to fall on it. And that'll bring up second down.
Fumble on the play. Recovered by the Bobcats. It's second down.
Just over 4 minutes to go here in the second quarter. After the rain started to fall, it kind of threw everybody for a loop. Suddenly the momentum kind of flipped. The atmosphere definitely changed. More than just a weather pattern. 3 minutes and 51 seconds. Second down and 11, ball's at the 15. Carson under center. Drop it back to pass. Fires over the middle. Ball was intended for Castleman. Had it in his chest, and as he's hit, it pops out incomplete. And that'll bring up third down and 11.
Bobcat pass falls incomplete. Will be third down. Ladies and gentlemen, we do remind you, please do not stand along the railing at the bottom of the bleachers. Again, please do not stand along the railing at the bottom of the bleachers.
That'll stop the clock with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go. Third down and 11 coming from the 15. Carson's under center. Straight back to pass. Lobs went up to the corner for Travarius Flood. Catch it. To me, it looks like it landed right at his arms, and he walked it just in the front of the pylon, but we didn't get any kind of signal for anything.
Bobcat pass signaled incomplete. It will be fourth down.
I can't wait to go back and see that one because I want to see exactly what they saw. I do not know. From our angle, it looked like a great over-the-shoulder catch. Fourth down and 11, so right where you were just a few moments ago as well. .334 to go here. Carson, he's under center, too wide. Dropping straight back to pass. Tosses one. Trevarius, he's got it that time. Tie goes to the receiver. Touchdown, Trevarius Flood. That's his second of the night.
Nolan Carson pass complete to number 11, Trevarius Flood. Touchdown, Bobcats.
We said from the jump you needed
him
on the field.
On the play.
That's unfortunate. Did not see that until right now. Kevin, with his optimism, is hoping, saying that it probably was after the play. We're going to discuss it and figure it out here. After the kick, or on the kick.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct signaled against White's Creek. The penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
So Will White will line up his extra point attempt. We were confused because he signaled for White's Creek, and then he signaled back to Greenbrier and did a kicking motion, which was – just couldn't figure that out. White on to attempt the extra point. Snap, set. Castleman's going to pick it up and look to throw it. Tosses it to Luke Meyer. Look at him with the bear claw. My goodness. Wingspan, hand size, all the things that you measure in the NFL. Working well for Luke Meyer tonight.
27 seconds remaining in the first half. Your score, Greenbrier 15, White's Creek 0. So White's kick is going to sail into the back of the end zone.
and that'll be a touchback. White's Creek will set up on the 20 here in just a moment.
Kickoff will go through the end zone for a touchback. White's Creek will take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
What? I do apologize. White's Creek's band is killing it across the field here. It is very loud and very powerful. I don't know how that's coming across the microphone. Do apologize if it's a little overbearing. Unfortunately, we can't mute that amongst anything else. So we'll get rolling here. They are the first play. Nolan Carson to make the tackle. 10 on the keep. No, it was 3, Kevin. Nolan tackling Nolan there.
Nolan on the reception. Nolan Carson with a ridgetop collision tackle for loss. It's second down.
So second down and 17 coming up here. 3 minutes to go here in the first half of play. Bobcats striking twice now. Nolan Carson to Trevarius Flood. And then moments ago, the probably not planned 2-point conversion. I don't know. But it worked. As Castleman kept it, he tossed it to Meyer. Meyer, using that big hand of his, was able to reel it in. Second down and 18 coming up here for the Cobras. They're in the shotgun. Bobcats showing blitz. They back it off. Now they're bringing the heat. Gets the pass away. Led him too far, did Pierce. That'll fall incomplete. Stop
White
the clock.
White pass falls incomplete. It's third down.
The third down and 18 ball is going to be at the 12-yard line. So again, third down and 17. White's Creek, they're in the shotgun. They got three wide to the right side as they're moving right to left here. Drop it back to pass is Pierce. He's under pressure. Still holding on to him. He got free. Launches one to the middle of the field. And that'll sail incomplete. Preston Pointer had him around the waist.
Not, fourth down.
Was not able to pull the feet down all the way. Fourth down and 17. Ball's at the 13. 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go. Still running on the field is White's Creek to get their personnel out there. Trevarius Flood is going to drop back in anticipation to receive a punt. Gets the kick away. Bounces at the 35, rolls up to the 40, and kind of goes off to the left.
White's Creek punt. Down to the Cobras, 43-yard line. First down, Bobcats.
So two-minute drill. See if we can't get another one just here before the half. And as we're trying to get things settled out here, looks like the Bobcats may have accidentally broke the huddle with 12.
Prior to the snap, illegal substitution sent against the Bobcats.
And the Bobcats will also take a timeout here with 2 minutes and 9 seconds.
A five-yard penalty will remain first down. Timeout, Bobcats. Continuing our recognition of our Bobcat football sponsors, First Choice Fabrication, the Law Offices of Converse and Underhill, Unique Crete, R&M Electric, SL Searcy and K. Mayo Nance with Searcy Realty and Auctions, Witz Barbecue, Greenbrier United Methodist Church, Pro Solutions, Jody A. Doris, Attorney at Law, Choice Auto Sales, LLC, Greenbrier Masonic Lodge, Sean Brooks Insurance, Springfield Glass and Exteriors, Trey Sherrod and Sherrod CPA Office, and Greenbrier Pizza and Pub.
So first and 15 coming up here on the ball's at the 47-yard line. Carson, he's in the shotgun, drop it back to pass. Looking to set up a middle screen. There's Dalton Wilbur with the reception. Dances around. Looks like he's going to get close to the original line of scrimmage.
Screen pass complete to number 24, Dalton Wilbur.
Another
to the 44-yard line. It's second down.
So that's another decent call here, especially with White's Creek just jetting, running straight upfield every time. Carson felt the pressure tremendously quickly, able to dump that one off just in time. Minute 33 to go here, second down and 12 coming up. So they did not give Dalton Wilbur the credit rolling around on his butt to the original line of scrimmage. Carson's going to be in the shotgun. He's directing traffic. Luke Meyer is wide to his left. Flood and Castleman wide to the right. Here comes Meyer in motion left to right. Did have some early movement. The first Bobcat came out of his stance, but we think it may have been a little bit on the defense as well.
Oh, come on.
Looks like they are going to call it on the Bobcats.
False start signaled against the Bobcats as a 5-yard penalty remains second down.
That's just another one of those things that you deal with a band that is like White's Creek. They love to play, and they love to play the entire game. So you weren't planning for that coming into the night. In fact, I don't think anybody knew that White's Creek was bringing their band. Just under a minute to go here. Carson's in the shotgun. Jailbreak, and they're finally going to bring him down back behind the line of scrimmage. Under 40 seconds to go now. Officially a third and 22 from the 46 coming up. And the clock is still going, ticking away. It's at zeros now. I should hold my tongue, but the count is three of the same.
That will be the final play of the half. Your halftime score, Greenbrier 15, White's Creek 0.
And so we've just been informed that we got a couple changes to halftime. No band performances tonight, so 15 minutes on the clock. We'll probably see you on the other side. What I was saying
Ladies
just before.
At this time, please welcome to the field your 2023 Greenbrier High School cheerleaders.
What I was saying just before is that the count tonight was three of the same officials on last week's crew that we had a lot of disagreements, to say the least, with. But we're going to put 15 minutes on the clock. We're going to reevaluate some stuff. We're going to do some halftime adjustments of our own. Folks, don't go far. We'll be right back with more Greenbrier football.
Welcome, everyone. You're listening to the Voice of the Bobcats, your home for everything that is Greenbrier sports and information. We have grown over the last few years, so here's what we have going on. Be sure to like and
follow us on X or Twitter or whatever they're calling it this week. Also on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube, and anywhere else you see the handle at VoiceOfCatsTN. We are committed to providing you the best resource for all information you might want to know about your trip to the Briar. We present to you live broadcasts of all Greenbrier High School football games on your fall Friday nights, as well as select dates for Greenbrier basketball and coverage of other Bobcat and Ladycat athletics. Be sure to tune in to VOTCLive.com for all the latest coverage. Greenbrier High School is an official partner school of the NFHS. That's the National Federation of State High School Associations, who are the educational body of most high school athletics in the nation and in the state of Tennessee. Greenbrier is a proud member of both the NFHS and the TSSAA. That's the Tennessee Secondary Schools Athletic Association, which is the governing body of prep athletics in the state of Tennessee. As a result, sometimes our broadcast may not be available in both a video and audio presentation. Please be mindful that when you see something on social media that is promoting such, Greenbrier football is not available in any live streaming video capacity. If you see it, it must come from us. The broadcast is Briar built and brought to you in part by the Greenbrier Athletic Club, for over 50 years has supported Greenbrier football and its junior pro football programs. For more information on the Greenbrier Athletic Club or for more information on how you can get involved, be sure to check them out on Facebook. And as for us, we are the voice of the Bobcats. We're like you. We're friends. We're family. And most importantly, we're fans of the Cats. I am Jim Sorrells, and I, alongside Kevin Criswell, we independently produce and present all the content you see and hear on our various social media outlets. Because this is an independently produced podcast, the thoughts and opinions of the hosts do not reflect that of Greenbrier Athletic Club, Greenbrier Schools, Robinson County Schools, or any other entity that may be assumed. This broadcast is provided to you free of charge via VOTCLive.com and has no monetary gain coming from it. All incidental music overheard is property of their respective artists, and at no point is any infringement of copyright intended. This broadcast is directed and produced by Jim Sorrells and Kevin Criswell. The support staff of Greenbrier Athletic Club is the President, Kevin Criswell, Vice President, Jim Sorrells, Secretary, Mike Parker. Your Junior Pro Football Commissioners are Rory Osborne and Andy Zahn. Your Junior Pro Cheer Commissioners are Emily Moses and Courtney Capps. The Greenbrier Athletic Club also has a dedicated staff of men and women committed to sportsmanship and development of our athletes. Operating the scoreboard for home contests will be Luke Young and Thomas Young, who together have served Greenbrier football for decades and hopefully decades to come. None of this you are seeing or hearing tonight was possible without their sacrifice and dedication to our community. We thank you for our support, and we will see you in the Briar. Thank you for joining us here. You have reached the landing page for TOTC Live and the Voice of the Bobcats. Located just north of Nashville, Tennessee, at the highest point between Louisville, Kentucky, and Nashville, Greenbrier High School has recently celebrated its 100th year of existence, and along with that, a long history of success on and off the field. For more information about Greenbrier High School and all that they offer to the community, be sure to visit ghs.rcstn.net. Greenbrier High School is an official partner school of the NFHS. That's the National Federation of State High School Associations, who are the educational body of most high school athletics in the nation and in the state of Tennessee. As a member of the NFHS and the TSSAA, that's the Tennessee Secondary Schools Athletic Association, Greenbrier High School is committed to sportsmanship at all levels. We'd like to remind everyone of this fact, and up first to tell us a little bit about the TSSAA is the voice of the Tennessee Titans, Mike Keith.
Hi, I'm Mike Keith, voice of the Tennessee Titans. Welcome to Greenbrier High School, home of the Bobcats. This game is being played according to the rules of the Tennessee Secondary School Athletic Association. TSSAA rules provide for fair competition among players. Our athletes recognize that judgment calls are made in good faith and that they must abide by the decisions of the official. Spectators are important in this process too. Fans can help promote good sportsmanship by observing rules of fair play. Each fan is requested to take personal responsibility for keeping this game at a high level of sportsmanship. spectators can support their high school by refraining from derogatory remarks or cheers. Good sportsmanship is one of the primary purposes of high school athletics. The TSSAA hopes you enjoy the game and support your athletes and your high school in a positive and sportsmanlike manner.
And now it's time for this week's Briar Beat. Greenbrier Lady Cat Soccer had a long close to the month of August, picking up Coach Chris Thomas's first career victory as head coach of the Lady Cats last Tuesday at Watertown. The Greenbrier offense was dominant, scoring 7 goals in the road win. Blair Pierce scored 5 times for the Lady Cats en route to being named the Farm Bureau Insurance Greenbrier Office's Athlete of the Week. She leads the team currently with 7 goals this season. She'll also go down as the first ever female to win this award, so congrats, Blair. Meanwhile, that same contest against Watertown, the reigning Robertson County Player of the Year, Emily Sheltra, added a goal and 3 assists to her totals on the year. Now with 7, she is keeping her name amongst the top talent in the state with assists. Goalkeeper Maddie Liana converted 14 of 18 save opportunities in the net. Now with 54 total on the year, she is placed 3rd in the state in the net. Last week, after the victory at Watertown, the Lady Cats took the show on the road to Gatlinburg to participate in the annual Smoky Mountain Cup. With 1 win and 2 losses on the week, at 2-3-1 now on the season, the Lady Cats are on the road at Springfield tonight and are on the road to Liberty Creek next week. Back home next Thursday night, 9-7, to take on Macon County. For Lady Cat Volleyball, they picked up their 2nd win of the year last night with a 3-0 match victory over Macon County. Now sitting at 2-6 on the year, they will have the weekend off and will pick up with Liberty Creek on Tuesday at home. And finally, at the pep rally earlier today, the senior class picked up the spirit stick after all the relay races had been completed. But that wasn't the only hardware recognized, as the Greenbrier High School Renaissance program was also recognized. This summer, Greenbrier High School was recognized at the Jostens Renaissance Global Conference in Orlando, Florida, as one of 21 schools in North America to be a recipient of the Jostens Renaissance Platinum Level School of Distinction Award. Advisor Samantha Grimes is joined on the field by Ms. Melanie Dickerson, Interim Director of Robertson County Schools, Dr. Bob Pruitt, the Supervisor of Secondary Education, School Board members Connie Hogan and Jeff White, Chad Bone, our longtime Jostens representative, and members of GHS's administration to celebrate this, the 3rd consecutive year that Greenbrier High School's Renaissance program met all 17 requirements to earn this level. We are very proud of our Renaissance program. Ladies and gentlemen, that'll do it for the Briar Beat this week. Don't go anywhere. We've got more coming right at you. Let's see what happened to the polls this week. Starting first with the Main Street Prep's Mid-State Top 5. Number 1 overall, Lipscomb Academy, still sitting at 0-2 after some big national powerhouse contests. Arguably still the best team in the state. We'll see how that shakes out as the weeks go on. Number 2 overall, Pearl Cone, who took the jump up from number 5 to number 2 this week. They're sitting at 2-0. Number 3, Brentwood, who moved up from number 9 last week at 2-0. CPA, after their loss, they're going to drop down to number 4 from number 2. And then finally, Brentwood Academy, they drop from 3 down to 5. Of course, this poll runs a full top 25 of note. Dropping out is Marshall County, now sitting at 1-1 after their shocking loss to Shelbyville last Thursday night. The Tennessean, however, lists a new number 1 overall in their mid-state poll for the larger schools. Number 1, of course, Pearl Cone. Sitting at 2-0, Keyshawn Tarleton hooked up with Darius Reed for the go-ahead touchdown midway through the fourth quarter, and the Firebird defense did not rest in their 15-11 win over CPA to move into number 1 this week. They're up against Creekwood later tonight. Lipscomb Academy, there, it's going to be their number 2. It was only a missed extra point in overtime that was the difference of their 31-30 loss in Alabama last week, but they will start their mostly state schedule here this weekend. Number 3, CPA. Number 4, Oakland. And number 5, Brentwood. In the smaller schools poll, a little local flavor with the Indians, now number 7 overall in the mid-state. East Robertson at 2-0 for the 2nd straight week. Isaiah Groves ran for over 200 yards. Last Friday, he did it in only 5 carries, running for 230 yards, averaging a whopping 46 yards per carry to give the Indians a 69-0 win over Houston County. They have a tougher road ahead tonight. We'll talk a little bit more about that here in just a second. Across the entire state, looking at Class 1A, the AP Prep poll, number 1 overall, South Pittsburgh with 8 votes. Number 2, Dresden with 8 votes.
votes. I would think that that should be a tie at first, but I am not a mathematician. Number 3, McKenzie. 4, Coalfield. 5, Whitwell. Number 6, Moore County. Number 7, Sail Creek. Number 8, Union City. 9, Memphis Academy of Science and Engineering. And number 10, Gordonsville. Looking at Class 2A, Riverside with 14 first-place votes and Milan with 5 first-place votes. And then there's number 3, East Robertson. 4, York. 5, Lewis County. 6, Marion County. Number 7, Huntington. 8, Hampton. Number 9, Smith County, who got 1 first-place vote. And rounding out their top 10 would be Waverly. For the Class 3A poll, Alcoa, it's all Alcoa. There's no question about it. All 21 first-place votes went to Alcoa this week. East Nashville comes in at number 2, arguably the best team in the mid-state, I would say. We'll come back to that at another time. Number 3, Gatlinburg-Pittman. Number 4, Dyersburg. Number 5, Covington. 6, Meigs County. Number 7, Shuckey-Doak. 8, Giles County. Number 9, Kingston. And number 10, Watertown. Skipping over to Class 5A at Knoxville West, again, runaway. 21 of the AP top votes go to Knoxville West, followed up by Henry County. Number 3, Nolensville. Number 4, Powell. Number 5, Page. Number 6, Mumford. Number 7, Centennial. Number 8, Beach. And finally, a tie at the bottom between Hendersonville and Springfield. Springfield and Henry County, they're playing each other tonight. We will check on that here in just a little while. Class 6A, Oakland gets 10 first-place votes for themselves. Number 2, Bradley Central, the Bears, at 8 first-place votes. Number 3, Maryville with 1 first-place vote. Number 4, Germantown with 2 votes. 5, Brentwood. 6, Farragut. 7, Colorville. 8, Riverdale. 9, Bearded. And 9, also a tie, Mount Juliet. Looking back at Class 4A, this is where things get fun as well. Greenville and Pearl Cone sitting atop. Greenville number 1, Pearl Cone number 2, splitting the votes, 10 apiece for them. 3, Elizabethton. Number 4, Upperman. Number 5, Haywood. Number 6, Hardin County. Number 7, Red Bank. Number 8, Stone Memorial. Number 9, Anderson County. Number 10, Macon County. A lot of those teams are in each other's region, and they will be beating each other up as the weeks go on. So this top 10 gets a little wild as the season stretches on. So pay close attention to this top 10, because it's going to be completely different here in a few weeks. Looking down locally here, local games of the week, thanks to David Wilson of the Main Street Preps. Be sure to pick up your copy weekly to read all about the happenings around Robertson County. We talked about East Robertson. They're on the road tonight to Monterey, taking on the Wildcats. Both teams 2-0. East Robertson is off to a red-hot start. They're averaging 55.5 points per game on this young season. They're headlined last week by that dominating 69-0 performance over Houston County, but Monterey, this Monterey team is a good Monterey team. Nothing to be denied right there. So keep an eye on that one as the night goes on. Another early region matchup to keep an eye on here locally. White House at 2-0 is on the road at Montgomery Central. Another local stool off to a hot start, White House Heritage. They're 2-0. They're traveling to Westmoreland tonight. They've got a first-year coach in Scott Murray. The Patriots have already eclipsed their win total from last year in just 2 weeks of play. Springfield, we talked about them. They're on the road to Henry County tonight. It's another early 5A early season battle. The Jackets were tested by the Bobcats and then bested by the Clarksville Wildcats. Tonight might be the real showing of what to expect out of this number 9 ranked team. Joe Burns, they're on the road at Whitwell. The Robeson era, the Red Devil football, will travel to the Chattanooga area to face the undefeated Whitwell Tigers. These two teams matched up last year in the playoffs, with Whitwell earning a victory 38-7 at home. Pearl Cone, they're at Creekwood tonight, and the Dixon Post's Casey Patrick is reporting that Creekwood has a tough matchup against Pearl Cone. Pearl Cone is a team that most fear anyway. They've taken down 2 powerhouses already to begin the season. For Creekwood to have any kind of chance, they've got to be healthy and error-free. Sounds familiar. No more procedural penalties or turnovers. That alone has been tough for the young Creekwood offense. These are just some of the games we're keeping our eyes on tonight. If there's any other scores of note, we will pass those along. Be sure to stick around with us. We got more coming right at you. Let's talk about a few stadium policies and logistics changes for 2023. Greenbrier High School invites you to check out Greenbrier football at Bobcat Field. But before visiting our campus, we'd like to take a moment to tell you about the active construction in the area surrounding Greenbrier Middle and Greenbrier High School. With that being the case, we have a few changes to logistics and parking this year. Entry information, every game that the Bobcats play on a Friday night will be $7. Tickets available via GoFan only, unless you have already purchased a PSL or season ticket. All children, school age and above, must have paid admission for entry. If purchased via GoFan, your only point of entry is going to be the main gate next to Greenbrier Middle School. The gates behind the home side, entry via Parker Avenue, are reserved for season ticket holders only. The main gate will also have the pass list and accept TACA cards as well. Concessions. Now here's the good one. Cash or card. All the essentials will be available. Burgers, hot dogs, funnel cakes, candy, popcorn. The Greenbrier Athletic Club and Greenbrier High School proudly sell Coca-Cola products at their concession stands. Seating. With the exception of the reserved middle section on the home side, bleacher seating is available first come, first served. There are no tents, awnings, or camping chairs allowed in Bobcat Stadium. Seats with backs that affix to bleachers are permitted, granted they do not affect the viewing area of those around you. We know it's hot, and while there is not an umbrella policy, please be mindful not to block the view of those around you. Season ticket and PSL holders will be required to show their ticket in order to sit in the reserved sections. And speaking of seating, the visitor bleachers are brand new for 2023. The county installed them prior to graduation past spring as a part of the larger facilities project that's going on. Please be mindful of the blocked off areas behind the visitor stands as these will not be wide open for play as usual. Other stadium policies. As previously stated, Greenbrier High School does not enforce an umbrella policy, and those should go without saying. The following are prohibited, but not limited to, the usual stuff. Fireworks, drones, hoverboards, Bluetooth speakers, etc. No animals allowed with the exception of certified service animals with proper documentation. Food items, including outside food, beverages, and including but not limited to hard plastic or metal bottles, cans, plastic, glass, other beverage containers, and all coolers are prohibited. We encourage you to bring your artificial noisemakers, for example, a cowbell. But please leave all electronically amplified devices and explosives at home. Be warned. The TOSAA is taking sportsmanship very serious, effective this fall. This list may also include other items such as, well, train whistles, for one. Talking to you, Portland. Parking. The gravel section behind the home grandstand is reserved for PSL holders with a parking pass. Be prepared to show your pass to gain entry. There is no parking allowed inside of the gates other than medical and game personnel. Limited parking is available on the front side of Greenbrier Middle School. But please note, parking in the bus lanes of the cut through between Greenbrier High and Greenbrier Middle Schools will also be on a limited basis. Your main area for parking will be Greenbrier High School. If your vehicle is found in an area with security fencing or signs posted, you may be subject to tow. We have highlighted areas in a provided map on all of our social media channels. Bathrooms. Due to the active construction, the bathrooms usually located in the north end zone will be inoperable for this season. We have placed portable units conveniently located on either side of the stadium. Broadcast information. Live play-by-play audio via VOTCLive.com, at VoiceOfCatsTN on Facebook, YouTube, or Twitter and X. We do provide a local simulcast in stadium only on 103.9 FM. But note, Greenbrier High School is an official NFHS partner school. However, video will not be broadcast. If you see anything claiming otherwise, it is a scam. Please report it. Sportsmanship. Be informed. If you are ejected at the TOSAA sanctioned event, your school will be fined. The TOSAA's Legislative Council approved rule changes over the summer to its unsportsmanlike conduct by spectators policy that now includes a minimum $250 fine to a school when it has a fan ejected during a contest. The new rule was included to supplement an already existing policy that includes a $250 fine for any fan that comes onto the field or floor during an incident. And there is a possibility of other, quote, non-monetary disciplinary action, including but not limited to probation and or restricted probation for the entire athletic program. With over 700 ejections during the 2022-2023 school year, this change comes as a direct response to a rise in fan misconduct. While a referee cannot remove a fan, if a contest is stopped for any reason to deal with an unruly situation, the contest officials can ask the administrators of the host school to remove anyone from the area of play. And that are your 2023 stadium policies and logistics for Greenbrier High School.
Back to work there on first down. Quarterback keeper for the Cobras.
Left side, White Creek, to the 17-yard line. It's second and seven.
Do apologize. Everybody is sending us some messages on Facebook and have not seen them.